Now let's get back to chapter 7, and this time we're going to work with syringes where we get to look at the doctor's order and the medicine label that goes with it. We'll try to calculate how many cc's possibly or milliliters that we need to put into a syringe. But first thing I'm going to do is click on the free textbook website. So again, I will go to chapter 7, and then I will go to a different exercise. This time I'm going to go to additional exercises. Now notice on this screen that you will have several labels. Just kind of scroll through those slowly. You'll come back to them to refer to the strengths on each of the labels. And for question number one, you have a syringe here. Notice it's a 20cc syringe. Notice that the top of the plunger is at the line 20cc. So if you were filling up a syringe, you would fill it up and measure it by the top of the plunger, not the bottom. Your order is for Depakote, 0.6 g, IV, and you are converting your answer to cc's. And obviously you're doing it because your 20cc syringe is above. So if you look at the Depakote label, notice that you have a strength of 500 mg/5 mL. Well, that is your strength where you are going to do a conversion. So if you look at my work, I started with a doctor's orders of 0.6 g, and I went to convert it by converting grams to milligrams. Now I know that 1 g is the same thing as 1,000 mg, and once it's in milligrams, I can use the strength on the label. 500 mg is the same thing as 5 mL. And then I know that 1 mL is the same thing as the cc, so I will take that answer and just put it in cc's. Now when you do all your multiplication and division, you end up with 6 cc's as your answer. So when I go back to my syringe, I can type in 6 cc's, and if I was to look at my syringe, 6 cc's would fill up to approximately this point. And so you'd put the top of your plunger at 6 cc's. Okay, question two. I have another syringe here. It's not quite as clear, but this is a 10cc syringe. Notice that each cc is clearly labeled, and then you have 5 tick marks between each one. So each one would be 0.2 cc, each little line. And I am looking at Nubane 56 mg IV, and I want to know how many cc's to put into my syringe. Let me scroll up to the Nubane label. The Nubane, as we get to it, was near the top. And you're always looking for a place where you see some kind of concentration, because this tells us we get 10 milligrams of this medicine in each milliliter. How would that work look? Well, I'm supposed to get 56 milligrams, and I want to use the strength, so I'm going to cancel out the milligrams, and 10 milligrams is the same thing as 1 mL, and I can cancel out milliliters because a milliliter is the same thing as a cc. So I would need a total of 5.6 cc's. So let me scroll back down. And 5.6, I'll type that in the box. And also, just for your reference, keep in mind, 5 is approximately right here. Each tick mark is 0.2, so you would go 3 tick marks above 5.0. So it looks like about right there. And again, this is a little hard to read, so in real life and in practice, you would want to pick a syringe that would be easy to read and something that would be easy for you to fill up. But 5.6 will be 3 tick marks above 5. Okay, now we have a 5cc syringe. So the top of the plunger is at the 5cc, so if it was actually full, it'd have that much in it. Each cc is clearly marked, and each tick mark between the cc's are 0.2. So I'm looking at 7.5 milligrams of verapamil, and I want to see how many cc's I'll have. So let me scroll up to the verapamil, and I'm going to look for the concentration, which I see right here, 10 milligrams per 4 milliliters. So if I go to look at my work, how did I use that? You'll notice that I started with 7.5 milligrams, and I'm going to cancel out my milligrams using the strength. 10 milligrams is 4 milliliters. I'm going to cancel out my milliliters because a milliliter and a cc are the same. So it looks like my final answer would be 3 cc's. So I can go back and type that in. So let me scroll down. 3 cc's. And if I was filling it up, that would be much easier to read, and I would actually fill it up to the 3 cc mark. Okay, number 4. This is also another syringe. It is a 3 cc syringe, a little hard to see. And this 30 in the M actually represents minims. You won't see this too often for the examples in our book, but they have occurred. And we are going to do methadone, 8 milligrams, and we want to figure out how many cc's to put in. So scroll up to methadone. And there's your methadone label. Now this one you're going to have to be a little bit careful about reading it, but there's 1 milliliter in this entire thing, and there's 10 milligrams of medicine. So when I went to do this calculation, I looked at how much methadone I was supposed to receive, which was 8 milligrams. I used the fact that 1 milliliter had 10 milligrams of medicine, which made my milligrams cancel. And then I used the fact that a milliliter is the same thing as a cc, leaving me with 8 tenths of a cc. So I will go back and type in the answer, 8 tenths. And then I'll try to identify where that would be on this syringe. Now, 8 tenths is somewhere in between a half and 1. And we're looking at the top set of interval tick marks because that's a cc. Now, 8 tenths of a cc, we're looking at 1 half is 0.5, 0.6 would be the next one, 0.7 would be the next one, 0.8, approximately, that's where you would put your medicine. So you try to get the top of the plunger to be exactly at 0.8. Okay, number 5, we're seeing several more labels again. And then our question says, and this, notice the syringe is a lot prettier, so this is a much better picture than what we had on the previous example. It says, read the order, use the appropriate label found above, look at the syringe, and calculate the dosage if necessary. We are going to look at the Fragmin label, and we want 7,500 units, and we're going to try to figure out how many cc's that is. So Fragmin, if we scroll up, it's actually this first one. And notice that this is 10,000 international units per milliliter. Because our problem started with units, that's actually the one we're going to use. So I'm going to show you my work where I started with 7,500 units. And then I used the strength of 10,000 units per milliliter. And then each milliliter is the same thing as a cc, so we're looking at 75 hundredths of a cc. So I could type that in. And now trying to figure out where 75 hundredths would be. Now that's going to be exactly in the middle of a half and one. And again, each little tick mark was a tenth, so that's 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, so I would try to be between 0.7 and 0.8. You may want to pick a different syringe if you're having difficulty reading this one, or you may want to convert it to minims to fill it up correctly. But whatever syringe you pick, you want to make sure it's easy to read and easy for you to fill up so that you don't make any mistakes. Okay, number 6. Several more labels again. And this time it says, read the order and use the appropriate label, look at the syringe and calculate the dosage. Now this order is Humulin BR, insulin 42 units, and then we're supposed to convert it to units. So guess what? There's no conversion. When I went to go do work, there's really nothing to do. It's already in units. There's no need to convert it. Just jump up to Humulin BR just to look at that label real fast. Humulin BR is 100 units per milliliter. So it's already in units, so there's really nothing else I need to do. You actually have a total of 10 milliliters in the entire container, but it's in a strength of 100 units per milliliter. If it's already in units and you want to fill up a syringe in units, there isn't a conversion you need to do. So it'll stay 42 units, and then you'll notice that 42 is going to be the second tick mark above 40. Each little tick mark is going to be one unit. If you were to look at it closely, you'll see that there are 10 little tick marks from 40 to 50. And so the second one would be 42. So you'd fill it up to that point.